how do car loans work? In this video, we're going to go over some of the fundamentals as well as some of the misconceptions and learn how to calculate loan terms in Google Sheets or Excel. Now let's start with an example and talk about the most important variables that affect your loan. As of end of 2022, the average car price was $47,680 for a new auto and $28,195 for a used vehicle. So the first thing that will affect your loan cost is the price of the car you want to buy. We are going to assume we want to purchase a used vehicle for $28,000. The second thing that affects your loan is the amount of your down payment. The more you pay upfront, the lower the loan amount and overall financing charges. Consumer Reports recommends putting at least 20% as down payment on your car. The average amount of down payment has been about $7,000 for new cars and $4,000 for used cars. If you are trading in your old car, you would get a credit toward the new purchase, so it would reduce your loan amount further. To get a fair price for your old car, check out Consumer Reports Black Book Estimator or Kelley Blue Book. In our example though, we don't have an old car to trade in. Now the loan amount is the amount of money you will actually borrow from the lender toward the purchase of the car. It is not though the total cost of the loan. That would include interest and fees. In our example, we would take the $28,000 and subtract the $5,000 down payment to calculate how much we are short and need to borrow. Now, the average loan amount for new cars is about $41,500 and $28,000 for used vehicle. Based on our calculation, we are short $23,000, so we need to borrow that amount. Next, we need to specify the loan term, which is the time you have to repay the loan. Shorter terms usually mean higher monthly payments but lower overall interest costs. The average loan terms are almost 70 months for new cars and 68 months for used ones, which is almost 6 years. We are going to assume 5-year period, which is 60 months. Finally, we reach the one very crucial variable, the interest rate, which determines the cost of borrowing. Lower rates mean paying less overall in financing. Note that we are using APR interest rate, which stands for annual percentage rate, as it includes all fees associated with the loan, such as origination or prepayment penalty fees. Now, car loan providers are required to provide APR rates so that you can compare loans apples to apples. It makes it easier for you to look at two loans and see which one is better for you. Suggestion: before you visit a car dealership, research car loans online to avoid accepting loans with unfairly high rates and being pressured to accept their terms when you are at the car dealership. You can use bankrate.com to find private car loan rates or even check with your local bank. The average car loan rates are around 6% for new cars and 10% for used ones. But that does not tell the whole story because your credit rating affects the interest rate that you can get. Additionally, credit score also affects whether you get approved for a loan and get favorable loan terms. Let's briefly talk about your credit score. It is a 3-digit number that represents your creditworthiness. Lenders use it to assess the risk of lending you money, including car loans. The base FICO scores range from 300 to 850, and a good credit score is above 670. According to Experian, one of the major credit reporting agencies, 67% of Americans have a FICO score that is considered exceptional, very good, or good. If you are in the 33% of people with fair or poor credit score, you need to do extra due diligence to avoid being taken advantage of through bad car loan terms. Now, to make this more confusing, Experian, that provides some industry average information, categorizes credit scores into 5 different groups: super prime at the very top, then prime, non-prime, subprime, and deep subprime at the bottom. Let's take a look how your credit score impacts the interest rate you can get. Borrowers in the highest group, the super prime credit score above 781, can typically secure car loans with average interest rate of 4.75 for new cars and 5.99 for used vehicles. Now, borrowers with subprime credit scores between 501 to 600 can expect much higher interest rates, averaging at 1079 for new cars and 1746 for used vehicles. So you can see how credit scores significantly affect the interest rate offered to borrowers with lower scores, resulting in higher interest rates. Now, you may have the same question I had. Why the interest rate for used cars are so much higher than for new cars? Aren't these loans and cars more expensive, so have more risk? Well, that is true, but there are also other factors that make the used cars loans more risky. The first one is used cars have already experienced depreciation, which means they are worth less than their original purchase price. There is also a higher probability of mechanical issue or need for repairs. Also, used cars have a lower resale value, so the lenders have a worse chance of recovering their investment in case of default. And finally, car manufacturers and dealerships often offer different financing incentives and low interest rates on new cars to encourage sales. We covered most of the variables affecting your car loan, and now we want to know the total cost of our loan. You can always use a loan calculator online to quickly compare multiple loan scenarios. However, using Google Sheets or Excel is very useful because you can customize calculation, track different scenarios, save them, and see how variables affect the cost of your loan. It's not just like a snapshot in time you can easily forget. Now, going back to our example, let's say we have a good credit score, so we're going to use APR of 7.7%. The formulas that we are going to be using in Google Sheets or Excel are the PMT, rate, NPER, which is number of periods, and PV formulas. All of them use similar variables, which we will define on the left. Most of the time, the first thing you want to calculate is the monthly payment. In order to do that, you need to know the interest rate, the loan terms in months, and the loan amount. We can use the PMT formula to do that. Replace the rate with the interest rate by dividing it by 12 to convert it to monthly rate. Then NPER is the loan term in months, which we have the 60 months. And PV, which stands for present value and is the loan amount. Now you have to put negative before that in order for the monthly payment to be a positive number. And based on this, our monthly payment would be $463. Once you have monthly payments, you can calculate the total cost of the loan and the total interest you would pay during the 5 years. The total cost of the loan is the monthly payment times the number of payments. So 463 in our case times the 60 months, which equals to $27,784. If you subtract the original $23,000 that we borrowed, we find out that we paid $4,784 in interest for the loan. Now, that is not the only way to use Google Sheets or Excel to calculate car loan information. Let's say you know that you want a loan no longer than 36 months and you don't want to pay more than $550 a month on an $18,000 car loan that you need to borrow. What is the interest rate that you need to find to get these terms? We can use the rate formula to find that. Replace the NPER with the loan term in months, PMT with the monthly payment, and PV with the loan amount. Remember about the minus in front of it. Now the result is 0.5%, which definitely doesn't make sense because this is expressed as a monthly interest rate as our monthly payment and loan term variables were monthly. So we need to multiply it by 12 to convert it to an annual rate of 6.3%. Further, if we use the same formulas for the total cost of the loan and total interest rate, we would pay $1,800 in total interest over the 3-year period. Similarly, let's say you know the lowest interest rate you're likely to receive being 11%, and you can afford to pay $550 a month on a $29,000 car loan. For how long would the loan have to be in order to pay it off? We can use the NPER formula to calculate that. Replace the rate with the interest rate divided by 12, the PMT with the monthly payment, and PV with the loan amount. Now we find out that it would take us 72 months to repay a loan with these terms, and the total interest would be over $10,000. Finally, if you want to know how much down payment you need to make in order to qualify for a loan, let's say with 13% interest rate with $600 monthly payments for 48 months, you can use the PV formula. Replace the rate with the interest rate divided by 12, then NPER with the loan terms in months, and PMT with the monthly payment. The loan would have to be for $22,365 or less. So, if you want a $30,000 car, that means you would have to make a down payment of $7,635 to make this work. The total interest on this loan would be $6,435.
Thanks so much for watching.